Hey guys, didn't see you there. Really quick, gotta check all my Instagram comments. There's so many! That would take me all day! I get it, I'm attractive. So today I wanted to try something a little bit different. I was gonna galaxy a tuna sandwich, and then I was gonna try some crazy meals from Del Taco. But then I decided I'm almost 30, and I don't want to kill myself today. So instead I decided to try having my own talk show. But this isn't gonna be a normal talk show. It's gonna be a really, really bad one. Cheap. I have no money for this. I spend all my money on this house. When I walked in to look at this house, the realtor said, "Oh, is this for you and your family?" And I said, "Nope, just me." I'm not alone all the time though. I have a crazy demon ghost that lives in my vents. Hey Sarah!
Kill your mother, Shane. Kill her.
I don't want to do that, Sarah.
Well then fuck you, Shane. But I do love your eating videos.
Oh, you. Help. Let's go to the closet. So I want my talk show to be a little bit different. So basically what I'm going to be doing is driving around in my car, taking my guests on an adventure, and then making them Uber themselves back home because I don't want to pay for the gas money. Now my first guest is obsessed with Harry Potter, so I thought it would be fun if we had a Harry Potter adventure day. He has no idea. Let's go pick him up. All right, we're picking up our first guest, Garrett, and look at him, he is just hanging out by the trash cans. Come on in! Yeah, that's it. Yeah, come in.
Hey.
Welcome to the show!
Thank you. I'm very excited to be here. Did you see that dog?
No, but I saw the trash cans.
Yep, that's where I live. Expectation!
Hey Garrett, welcome to the show.
Thanks Shane, it's really good to see you.
Buckle up, cause we're about to we're about to go on a magical ride because today is all about Harry Potter.
Really?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yes, so we are going to be doing some Harry Potter themed things today. First, we are going to go to Starbucks because I heard that they have a secret menu item, which is the Butterbeer Frappuccino.
I know a little something about that, actually.
What?
I tried to get it once, and they said no.
Well, today they're going to say yes because I'm famous, and you're not.
Oh, boy.
So, let's talk about how we know each other. So we met on Tinder. First of all, let me just start off by saying, you super liked me, which I didn't even know what that meant.
Because I thought he was cute.
What does a super like mean?
A super likes when you accidentally press the blue button. And then someone comes on way too strong, and then you end up being best friends with them. I'm kidding.
That is too dark. I just almost crashed. Here's what happened. So he super liked me, and I was like, okay, listen, I'm gonna go through his pictures. Your pictures were fucking terrifying.
Wait.
None of them looked like you. You were in a banana costume. You were, like, giving a little girl a cigarette. And then there was one of you, like, looking off into the sunset, but it looked like you were about to kill yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Jump off the cliff.
That's this one?
And that's when I was like, that's my soulmate. So then we were talking on there and you were like kind of a douchebag, but I liked it. You were like being kind of like,
I was not
too cool. Like you're like, yeah, whatever. Like, yeah, chill, bro. And then we set up our date. So tell us what happened.
I'm really, really phenomenal at setting up dates.
You were 2 hours late.
I was 2 hours late. And I think what happened is that like, I just forgot to, I didn't go to Trader Joe's because I have this whole thing that I like to do when I go on date.
This whole thing. How many times do you do it?
I mean, I don't do it a lot. Shane here seemed very, very cool, so I sue me for going all out. Oh, I did.
That's so sweet.
So anyways, I packed a picnic, a gorgeous one.
Guacamole.
Chicken curry.
I really pretended to like it.
Dude, that Shane just said hurt my feelings so bad.
Ew, no, why? Like, you're amazing, stop.
Chips.
Wine.
Roofies.
Roofies. Was there roofies?
There was roofies.
I don't remember.
My ass does. We went on this date and he took me around the city and you took me on like a rooftop and you were like, hey babe, look at the fucking world, babe. And I was just like, oh my god, this is amazing.
Well, I actually was kind of pinched for a location, so we ate in front of my uncle's house. Which sounds like the least charming thing in the world, but it's a handsome house. How was it?
Terrifying.
Stop!
I thought you were a crazy serial killer. I thought we were in front of a stranger's house. I thought they were gonna come out and tell us to get the fuck off their lawn. I didn't know what was happening. I was texting my friend the whole time, giving him my location, giving him the pin on the Google map, and I was like, if I die,
no.
Like, you can take over my channel. Like, it was serious. So we stayed up like all night talking. We were laying on my bed, fully clothed, and then I went in for the kiss, and then you said, ooh, I don't know. And I was like, what does that mean? So then we just laid there for like 7 hours.
We had a good 7 hours. of clothing on lying down.
So then, after that, we went on like, I don't know, a month more's worth of dates, and then we had a big uncomfortable talk where we realized that neither of us were getting boners, and I wasn't jerking off thinking about you. No, in all seriousness, it was the first time that's ever happened to me where I've like dated somebody and then actually it didn't work out, but I became like really good friends with them, and now you're like one of my best friends.
Yeah, which is really good. When Shane and I first met, we had a really remarkable, like, you know, it was strong. It's like I knew him for a decade. And
it was really, honestly, getting real and emotional, guys, cue the emotional music. It really felt like I was meeting somebody that I was supposed to meet my whole life, and we were almost like soulmates, and not romantically, just like, I know he's gonna be my friend until I die. It was like a similar thing I had with Drew. Except for, like, you kind of look like me, and I probably could jerk off thinking about you.
And that's what I mean. Well, people had been telling me for the past, I don't know, probably 8 years that oh, you look like Shane Dawson, you look like Shane Dawson. I would always Google that when people said that, and the one that I always knew
was like,
and then you go, ugh! But the Shane that I always knew, and the one that I kind of thought you currently looked like, was, like, the straightened hair. And I was like, yeah, I kind of see it. I never saw the Shane with, like, the cut hair and, like, the scruff.
Right,
and, like,
right.
The more handsome. The more handsome Shane. It was a very handsome picture, and
yeah,
I did
how
super
like
it.
Like, really handsome?
Like an 8.7.
Really?
Yeah.
Like 10?
Yeah.
But then when you saw me in person, you were like 6.3?
No, it was still pretty solid, actually.
I'll take it. Okay, we are at Starbucks. We're gonna go in and get this Frappuccino. I'm really excited for us to have this magical experience.
I really hope that it works out. It really damaged me last
time. That's exactly what I said after our first date.
Oops.
So we're at Starbucks and we're supposed to get the Frappuccino, but he got a little distracted.
This is the care of magical creatures. This is what Hagrid would teach if this were
ABC. This is terrifying to you. Okay, so how are we gonna ask for this?
They're not gonna know what I'm talking about. I'm afraid that when I ask for a butterbeer Frappuccino, they're gonna ask me how old I am.
Well, I have the recipe with me, so worst case scenario, I just give them the recipe and then they figure it out.
You're that prepared?
I'm very prepared. I had 5 condoms on our first date.
Ooh. Hey, how's it going, man? I read something on the internet and I wonder if you guys could do it. Do you know what a butterbeer Frappuccino is? Well, first of all, do you know what butterbeer is?
Like the Harry Potter drink?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. You look just like Harry Potter.
Have you ever seen Harry Potter?
Yeah.
That's a no. Okay, it was a success. They made it.
It's like butterbeer from Harry Potter. Do you guys know what I mean?
Yeah. What house are you in?
I'm gonna kill myself.
Hey, thanks guys for... Thank you.
All right, we are outside of Starbucks and we have it. Are you ready?
I'm gonna scream.
Do you want to take the first sip or should
I? I'm a Hufflepuff, and I think it's the Hufflepuff way to let your friend try it first.
As a true Slither buff,
that's not what that is.
I'm gonna take the first sip.
That's good.
Is it? Thumbs up. 10 out of 10. Thanks, Starbucks.
That's your reaction?
What do you want me to do?
I just got you a butterbeer Frappuccino. This is something magical and amazing.
I know.
Do you want me to do a Shane-style thumbnail with it?
Sorry. Just drink the fucking. Now that we have our butterbeer, our next activity is playing Quidditch.
Do you have the materials purchased?
No, I have no idea what it even means. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Now that I think about it, that was not that magical of a day, was it? I mean, we pretty much just went to Starbucks and had a very mediocre Frappuccino. Then we came back here and, well, did whatever the fuck that was. But hey, that's all you're worth.
Really?
No. We're going to Harry Potter Land!
fun. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the first episode of my show. Make sure to go over to Garrett's channel and subscribe, and check out the video we did over there. It got crazy.
Hey Garrett, you fucking trash can. Yep. I would like you to eat Taco Bell's Boss Nachos and a big ass sundae from Baskin Robbins. Yuck.
Also make sure to leave me a comment down below letting me know what guest I should have on next. Alright you guys, I will see you next time.
Shane? Are you gonna take me home?
No!
Hey Garrett, you fucking trash can!
Yep.
For today's Will It Combo, I would like you to eat Taco Bell's Boss Nachos and a big ass sundae from Baskin Robbins.
Mmm.
Yuck. Good luck.
Oh! Oh.